Hello students, how are you? Okay, so in today's topic we are going to discuss alcohol chapter. So alcohol, the whole alcohol properties we can discuss in this mind map. Okay, so first we'll discuss how the alcohol is prepared and how the reactions occur from alcohol. So to and from, both we'll discuss. Okay, so first you can see in this flow chart or this mind map, this the yellow arrow which I have written, that is coming towards alcohol side. So all yellow arrows are coming towards alcohol side. It means they are showing the preparation of alcohol. Okay, so yellow lines are indicating preparation of alcohol, and opposite lines, that is blue line, that is showing the properties of alcohol. Okay, so how alcohol can be prepared, that is indicated by yellow line, and how alcohol are converting into another product, that is shown by blue line. Okay, so let's we start. So first I am going to discuss, this is our first product. Okay, this is our first compound, we can say, sorry, alkene. Okay, so first is alkene. Okay, how to convert alkene to alcohol? So for alkene to alcohol, we can add water. Okay, again there is a two type of reactions occur. Alcohol in alkene, we can add water in presence of acid catalyst, that is called Markovnikov rule. It is the first one is a Markovnikov rule, in which the OH minus add to that unsymmetrical alkene where is the lesser number of hydrogen present. Means in this case we can get alcohol at the second position, not the first position. But if suppose from unsymmetrical alkene we have to obtain alcohol, means OH at the first position, terminal position, then we have to follow the anti-Markovnikov rule. For anti-Markovnikov rule, we have to add diborane, that is B2S6, or we can write BS3 whole twice. In presence of peroxide, hydrogen peroxide and basic medium, the alkene convert into alcohol. So from alkene to alcohol, there is a two ways, either Markovnikov rule or anti-Markovnikov rule. For Markovnikov rule, we have to add water in acidic medium. And for anti-Markovnikov, hydroboration reaction, means diborane, hydrogen peroxide and basic medium. Okay, this I can show you also so that you can easily understand. Okay, now you can see in this reaction, this is this reaction. Suppose this is unsymmetrical alkene, which is called propene. In this propene, or I can say if from propene to, if we have to conversion, convert propene to propane to all, means the OH is coming at the middle position. Okay, so in this case we have to follow the Markovnikov rule. For this Markovnikov rule, we have to add water in acidic medium, and according to Markovnikov rule, all of you know water means what? H plus and OH minus. The negative part attached to that unsaturated carbon atom where is a lesser number of hydrogen atom, means the OH minus attached to the second carbon. OH will be attached to the second carbon, H plus attached to the first carbon. So we can get propane to all, correct? But if coming in question conversion, convert propene to propane one all, and this is one step. Suppose it is given in direct conversion, it is in first step, one step. Then we can go for which reaction? Hydroboration reaction, okay? So what is hydroboration reaction? Hydroboration reaction is the reaction of alkene in which we have to add diborane, that is the formula of diborane, B2S6, or we can write BS3 whole twice, peroxide and OH minus, and there is a followed anti-Markovnikov rule. In this case, the OH minus attached to the first carbon. So you can distinguish from propene to, if you have to obtain propane to all, means second position, then Markovnikov, or first position, that is one all, anti-Markovnikov, that is hydroboration reaction. Okay, this is clear. Okay, similarly, okay, we can go to the next previous slide. Okay, so this is this reaction. So from alkene to alcohol, we have to follow either Markovnikov rule or anti-Markovnikov rule, means we have to add either water or we have to add hydroboration, we have to follow hydroboration reaction, right? Now the second is alkyl halide. From alkyl halide to alcohol, directly you can add aqueous QH or aqueous NH. So there is a no problem. X will be substituted by OH minus. It's also a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay. Now the next is from aldehyde or ketone. Okay. So if you have to obtain aldehyde and ketone, this is given. Okay. So how to convert aldehyde to alcohol? So aldehyde or ketone convert into alcohol by reduction. For that, we have to add suitable reducing agent. We can take lithium aluminum hydride or sodium boron hydride or hydrogen in presence of catalyst, nickel, platinum, palladium. Lithium aluminum hydride is very good, best reducing agent, very strong reducing agent. Still, we prefer sodium boron hydride because lithium aluminum hydride is very expensive. Okay, so aldehyde and ketone directly reduce in the presence of such reducing agent to form alcohol. But aldehyde forms primary alcohol and ketone forms secondary alcohol. So remember this thing, ki both will be reduced to into alcohol by any suitable reducing agent. But aldehyde gives 1 degree alcohol, ketone gives 2 degree alcohol. Okay, now come to the next point. Okay. Second is better we can go. This is the first, this is a second. Okay, I'm giving the numbering so that your remembrance will be easier for you. This is third, and the fourth is this carboxylic acid. I'm just discussing fourth. From carboxylic acid and even ester also. From carboxylic acid and from ester, we can directly obtain alcohol. This whole carboxylic COOH group convert into CH2OH group. So this carboxylic group and ester also reduced into alcohol in the presence of lithium aluminum hydride or hydrogen palladium catalyst. But in these two cases, we cannot add sodium boron hydride, because sodium boron hydride is reducing agent. Sodium boron hydride is mild reducing agent, means it not gives too much nascent hydrogen, because in this case there is only two nascent hydrogens required. But in these two cases there is a required four nascent hydrogen, means more hydrogen required, and sodium boron hydride is not very strong reducing agent. So instead of sodium boron hydride, so we cannot use that one. We have to use lithium aluminum hydride or hydrogen palladium catalyst. Now from amine, this is sixth one. From amine to alcohol, we can directly convert NH2 into OH by using nitrous acid, that is HNO2. And already you know HNO2 obtained from NNO2 and HCl. Am I clear? Okay. Now this conversion from aldehyde or ketone to alcohol, one is a reduction, but this reaction is the step up. Till we have discussed the first one, which we have discussed, this is not a step up. This is the same number of carbon. But in aldehyde ketone, if aldehyde ketone reduce, we can get the same number of carbon alcohol. But in aldehyde ketone, if we add RMGX, that is Grignard reagent, and followed by hydrolysis, we get alcohol, but by increasing the number of carbon. So remember, again I'm repeating, from aldehyde ketone to alcohol, if the carbon is same, means if you have to obtain 1 degree or 2 degree with the same number of carbon, so only reduction is required. But if we have to obtain aldehyde to ketone alcohol by increasing the number of carbon atom, I mean step up carbon atom, then we have to go with the Grignard reagent. We have to add Grignard reagent. Okay, I will explain you so that you can easily understand. Okay, just a minute. You can see over here. Okay, suppose this is aldehyde, this is ketone, or allylic ketone. Already I told, if we do the reduction, we can get same number of carbon alcohol. Okay, from aldehyde we can get 1 degree alcohol. From ketone we can get 2 degree alcohol. Right? And what is the reduction? This carbonyl group, which is present in both aldehyde and ketone, one hydrogen will be attached. One hydrogen will be attached at this carbon, and one hydrogen will be attached at this carbon. Okay, so this double bond will be vanished. So what we are getting, you can see this carbon, one hydrogen has attached. This oxygen, one hydrogen has attached, and this double bond convert into single bond. Right. So this is this reduction. Okay, I can erase this portion so that I can go for the another reaction. Okay, wait just a minute. Again, I will rewrite. Okay, so this is the reduction of aldehyde and ketone. I hope it is clear. There is no problem. Okay. Any doubt? You have any doubt? Anybody has any doubt? No? Good. So I was thinking, I was just discussing about this group. Okay? Okay. Now, in the second way, if we have to increase the number of carbon, then we have to add what? Grignard reagent. Better I can use the next page. Yeah, you can see over here. This is carbonyl group, in which if we add RMGX, all of you know, this R is the, Mg is the positively more positive, so R is a negative. In CO group, you know, C is the positively, oxygen is more negative. I can say partial negative, partial positive. Everywhere we have to write this partial term, okay? So now you, in this reaction, this, I'm just removing this partial charge, otherwise too much chaos will be there. So now this R is attacking to this carbon and pi bond is shifted to oxygen, right? So what will happen? You can see, I'm writing over here, at this carbon, sorry, single bond, wait. You can see over here, at this carbon, the R is attached and oxygen is negatively charged, at which MgX will be attached. And then it is followed by hydrolysis, okay? In acidic medium. Hydrolysis means what? H plus and OH minus. So now this OH oxygen minus attached to O, or we can say O, H plus will attach to O minus. So this part convert into alcohol. And this MgX, Mg attached with X comes in the form of byproduct. Clear? So here we are getting alcohol. In this case also we are getting alcohol. This is alcoholic group. But what happens here? One R is attached over here. Whether R or AR, aromatic, anything may be attached over here. So one carbon is increased over here. At least one carbon. This R may be methyl. If one carbon, methyl. Two carbons, ethyl. Three carbons, propyl. So how many carbon you have to increase? Accordingly, we have to take this R group, right? So this is step of conversion. It is used in the step of conversion. But you can take one example so that you can easily understand. Suppose it is, we are taking aldehyde. In this aldehyde, if you add, okay, this is one aldehyde. We are, instead of R, we are taking CH3, MgBr, okay? Instead of R, we are taking CH3, okay? So this CH3 attack to this carbon, okay? And MgX will be attached to, okay, this oxygen. What will obtain? I'm just writing over here once again. What will obtain? CH3, CO, MgBr, and CH3, okay? This CH3 is attaching an H, okay? Now this is followed by hydrolysis, okay? Just I've written here also. So when it will be hydrolyzed, this MgBr will be removed and OH will be formed. H will be coming. So what we are getting? CH3, CH3, OH, right? or we can say CH3, CHOH, CH3. This is propane 2-ol. We are getting 2-ol. So from aldehyde, always we get 2-ol. Whether propane 2-ol, not always 2-ol, it depends. If we take aldehyde, then propane 2-ol, then 2-ol. Okay? But if we take another aldehyde, that will be, we can get secondary alcohol. Shortcut, we can say, from aldehyde, we can get secondary alcohol except methanol, that gives primary alcohol. Okay? So this is, okay. So now come to the next point. Okay, we go and go for the previous slide. So these are the preparation of alcohol. Again, I'm repeating, tell me, yes. First, from alkene. Okay, so alkene. First is from alkene. From alkene, we have to apply Markovnikov, anti-Markovnikov. Second, from halide. In alkylide, we have to add aqueous QH or NaOH. From aldehyde ketone, either reduction of the same number of carbon or from step up Grignard reagent. From amine, HNO2 we have to add. From carboxylic acid, reduction. From ester, reduction by lithium aluminium hydride. So these are the methods for the preparation of alcohol. Okay, but alcohol also shows its properties, chemical properties. Now, okay, alkene to alcohol, water, hydration, and alcohol to alkene, dehydration. So now vice versa. So alkene to alcohol, hydration is occurring. From alcohol to alkene, dehydration. This is called dehydration. For dehydration reaction, we have to add suitable dehydrating agent. And what is suitable dehydrating agent? Concentrated sulfuric acid at 443 Kelvin, or H3PO4 we can take, or alumina we can take. Okay, so alcohol to alkene, dehydration, that is dehydrating agent. Okay. In this case, again, there is a follow what? Beta Seltzer rule. Okay. That is, it is just like a type of beta elimination. Now, alkyl halide to alcohol, we have to add aqueous QH, and alcohol to alkyl halide, we have to add SOCl2. Okay. From aldehyde ketone to alcohol, reduction. From alcohol to aldehyde ketone, oxidation. Okay, this is the reduction, opposite, oxidation. Reduction, oxidation. Reduction, oxidation. For reduction, lithium aluminium hydride. For oxidation, oxidizing agent. But for aldehyde, we have to, it will be alcohol converting to aldehyde by oxidizing agent, but that should be mild oxidizing agent. That is PCC or copper 573 Kelvin. But if in alcohol we add a strong oxidizing agent, that is K2CR2O7, then primary alcohol directly convert into carboxylic acid. So primary alcohol may be convert into aldehyde or may be convert into carboxylic acid. That depends whether it's mild oxidizing agent or strong oxidizing agent. For secondary alcohol, either you add mild oxidizing agent or strong oxidizing agent, you can get ketone only, right? Okay. Now, from Grignard reagent with aldehyde ketone, we are getting alcohol. And from alcohol to again aldehyde ketone, we have to add same oxidizing agent, that is PCC or copper 573 Kelvin. Okay. So these are the reactions vice versa. Okay. Now, ester, from ester to alcohol, reduction. From alcohol to ester, esterification reaction. Okay. Means in alcohol, we have to add suitable. We can add any carboxylic acid in the presence of acidic medium, we can get ester. So this mind map, just make an image and fit in your mind so that, so now you close your eyes, recall one image, alkene to alcohol, alcohol to alkene, root one. So you can numbering, give the numbering also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so that you can remember it, you can learn it, right? So thank you so much. So this is alcohol mind map conversion. So wait for the next class. In next class, we will discuss the next topic of the conversion. Okay. So, okay. Thank you so much. Right. Okay. So now we'll stop. I'm just end the meeting now.